A monkey just mind-controlled another monkey, so basically, we now live in a future where no monkey's actions can ever fully be trusted. Anthony here for D News, and a team at Harvard Medical School implanted a chip into the brain of a monkey that monitored the activity of 100 neurons in its brain. A second sedated monkey had 36 electrodes implanted in its spinal cord, and the two were hooked up via computer, allowing the first monkey to control the movements of the second. The sedated monkey had a joystick, and the master monkey was able to make it move that joystick towards goals on a screen with 98% efficiency. The goal, of course, being an army of mind-controlled monkey assassins. The goal is to help people suffering from limited or full paralysis due to spinal damage to regain full range of motion. So they do more testing and refinement, they make more advanced and smaller versions of the chip and electrodes, and they put them into a human. That is amazing and also sort of creepy at first thought. Somebody with a less than optimistic view of human nature might think that this could be used as a form of mind control, but the team says that because this just controls basic movement, not thoughts or intentions, and because an able-bodied person would still have their own brain-spine connections and be able to control their own muscles, no one's going to be hijacking anybody else's body anytime soon. Or maybe that's what the monkeys told them to say. This sort of augmented brain-body control has seen a lot of advancements in a very short amount of time. In 2008, University of Pittsburgh and Carnegie Mellon researchers were able to use a cruder implementation of this technology to have a monkey control a robot arm. And in 2012, Brown University showed paralyzed people using a more advanced version of that same brain-robot arm combo. Now, the chip in the brain is connected to a person or primate's motor neurons, which send directions to the limbs and the body. The researchers check what directions the motor neurons send and how a functioning body responds, and try to make the chip and electrodes match up to the same call and response. Now, this is the first time it has worked in a living thing, and even though the team is optimistic, they say a full brain-body control system with precise natural movement is very far off.
Hey, Anthony, why'd they use two monkeys and sedate one?
That's a good question, Katie Wayne from Animalist News. They used two monkeys because they didn't want to paralyze one for life just to run the test.
Seems legit, but I wonder how humane testing like this is overall.
You already have a video about that at Animalist News, don't you?
Yup!
And I guess this is where I tell everyone to check it out over on youtube.com/animalist.
Yup!
Will you make some Avatar references since I didn't?
Yup!
Great. What do you guys think of this? Spooky or spectacular? Let us know down below and subscribe for more D News. You got a real guttural yell for such a tiny lady.
It's a talent.